What's up, Grio fam? I'm your host, Nayo Campbell, and welcome to the Grio Top 3, where we count down the top 3 Black trending stories of the day. And coming in at number 3, Jason Momoa and Lisa Bonet announced their separation after 5 years of marriage. Momoa, who stars as Aquaman in the DC Comics film franchise, was introduced to the Cosby Show actress at a jazz club in 2005. Bonet later played Momoa's love interest in the 2014 film Road to Paloma, a part he wrote for her. The two then wed in October 2017. In a 2018 interview, Bonet said of their union, "I can't say it was full on from the moment we saw each other, but we have been together from the day that we met." And in an interview with the Huffington Post, Momoa described Bonet as his dream woman. However, on Wednesday, the couple released a joint statement via Momoa's Instagram page that read, "We have all felt the squeeze and changes of these transformational times. A revolution is unfolding, and our family is of no exception, feeling and growing from the seismic shifts occurring. And so we share our family news that we are parting ways in marriage. I am never here for a breakup, so I'm sending my prayers out to Lisa and Jason." Next up at number 2, TikToker Rory Teasley joked about getting older in the last video he posted before his death. Teasley, known by his handle Too Pumped for TV, had built a hefty TikTok following with nearly 291,000 followers who tune in for his comedic videos, TikTok dance challenges, and lively personality. But in a tragic twist of fate, a day after posting a video that poked fun at the pitfalls of aging, the 28-year-old TikToker was allegedly strangled by his longtime boyfriend, Dawkwin Jovan Watkins, on January 6th. Since going up, the clip has gone viral, with already over 256,000 views. The comment section has been flooded with messages of condolences for Teasley. In addition, the hashtag #RestInPeaceRoryTeasley has been circulating on the app, and over 43,000 posts have gone up. Watkins was arrested and is being held without bond on a charge of second-degree murder. And our top story of the day, coming in at number 1, Kanye West is back on stage again, and this time, it's the Coachella stage. Kanye West has been confirmed as the Coachella Festival headliner. Coachella confirmed on Wednesday the prolific hit maker will be headlining the annual 2-week extravaganza set to take place on April 15th through 17th and April 22nd through 24th at the Empire Polo Club in Indio, California. It will be making its return after the COVID-19 pandemic forced cancellations in 2020 and 2021. West will headline on Friday, April 15th and Sunday, April 24th, with performances also scheduled by Megan Thee Stallion, Doja Cat, Ari Lennox, and Vince Staples. Coachella originally announced their dates in June 2021, and Travis Scott was initially the headliner. However, the Sicko Mode rapper withdrew from the event in December following the Astroworld tragedy. 10 people died, including a 9-year-old, during Scott's headlining performance in Houston on November 5th after a stampede. A Change.org petition asking for his removal as Coachella's top star nabbed at least 64,000 signatures. West's confirmation as a replacement is another sign that he will be quite busy in the new year. A representative for the mogul revealed that he also intends to take his talents and Sunday service to Russia in the coming months. All right, Grio fam, this has been the Grio Top 3. Make sure you head over to youtube.com/theGrio for more videos like this, and also be sure to check out thegrio.com. Thank you all so much for watching.